internet was still pretty new. Most cameras still used film and there was no such thing as the iPhone. So let's look back at some of the best technology from that time and how things have changed. Steve Fenwick is here with us. Hey, Steve.
Good morning.
Hey, yeah. First up, I remember 1999 and the Y2K bug.
Oh, yes.
Everyone was frightened that the world was going to implode.
Yeah. That's right, yeah. Y2K was a big thing. A lot of people were under the impression that because computers only use the last two digits of the year, it never said 1999, it only said 99. So the big concern was that when it clicked over to 2000, that the computers having 00, everyone was worried that they'd think it's 1900 instead of 2000 and that the world would just come to a halt. Oh. So a lot of money was spent making sure that everything was compliant, that when it ticked over to the new year, that it wasn't going to be the zombie apocalypse, everything was still going to work.
Planes were supposed to fall out
that's
of the
right,
sky.
Yeah.
Everyone said they weren't going to get into an elevator
that's right,
on
yeah,
New Year's
yeah,
Eve.
That's right.
You know? Was it a scam?
Well, a lot of people think that there was a lot of money to be made by companies who were doing the compliance testing, right. But better safe than sorry, I think, was the attitude.
But the Italians were like, hey, we don't care. And then it ticked over and they went, we still don't care. and that was proof that actually nothing happened because everyone was saying, look, I told you, we spent billions of dollars and we saved you. And there was other countries like Russia just going, we did nothing and nothing was any different.
Your Y2K bug is Western conspiracy. Vote Trump. Now, phones have changed, of course.
Phones,
there was no smartphones.
Well, you've got to remember, iPhone was still 8 years away.
Yeah.
So back in the day, you were either a Nokia user or an Ericsson user. Ericsson and Nokia were the two big brands.
Not I'm me, holding I'm the Siemens user.
The 7110 and the 5110. And Sarah, I think, has got the GA628, which is also was one of the hottest phones of 99.
I was going to take a phone call. And all you did on the phone was
just talk,
call.
Sent messages and the battery.
No, you couldn't message.
Well, you could text on these phones, but you couldn't. The battery would last you 5 days because that's all you did was talk and text. So there was no need to charge the phone once a week.
I read an article because the 3210, the Nokia 3210, was my favourite phone. And I say long live the 3210. I read an article about a bloke who found a 3210 in the pocket of his suit that he'd worn to a wedding 2 years earlier and it still had two bars of battery on it.
Well, it's a big battery. Like the batteries were pretty big on them, so they did last a while.
Can I just show this? Look, have a look at this. Does anyone remember this?
A flip phone.
Best thing in the world.
You did also have the BlackBerry. If you're a corporate high flyer, the BlackBerry was also the gadget to have. It had the side winding button. Yeah. So if you ever saw people walking around town winding through their emails, had a physical keyboard as well. The BlackBerry was coming into its own also in 99.
Now, it would have been hard to take lots of cat photos on the camera, those sort of cameras.
Well, digital cameras were around, and when the resolution hit 1 megapixel, everyone thought, wow, what more could you need? 1 megapixel camera. This
what
is
are
the,
we up to now? I don't
well,
know what
our phones
means.
Can take 28, 23 megapixel pictures now.
Oh,
so
okay.
This, at the time, was revolutionary. It was a 1.2 megapixel.
It means dogs can see the telly because That's right. of those pictures.
Does it really?
Yes. But because of the pixelation on the telly, dogs could never watch telly. Now they can.
And a very good morning to all of our dog viewers out there.
My dog watches every day. I need a television on when I leave.
Can I just say the best thing about this phone is its pocket size.
It's a camera.
Yes. It's perfect.
Incredible too is that while you're sitting here, Steve, your phone was ringing and then you just went to your Apple iPhone on your watch, and then disconnected it.
Yeah,
it's amazing to think in 18 years we'll be laughing at your...
How primitive this is, that's right.
And the modem,
That was a dial-up modem, but back in 99...
I can't remember using this.
Well, that was...
How did it work?
Yeah, I thought it was an iPhone 7.
That's a dial-up modem. You'll see there's a phone line here. So remember the internet came across your phone line, made that really weird handshake noise when you were connecting. If you were on the internet, the phone was engaged. Well, here, you can hear the handshake noise right there. And anyone who was on the internet... The phone was busy, so people were saying, get off the internet, I need to make a phone call.
Yeah.
This is when you had a modem just like this, a dial-up modem as well.
Amazing.
But on the music side, the tapes were still pretty big, so the Walkman was still popular.
I loved my Walkman.
Yeah, so the Walkman
with Depeche Mode on it. I loved it.
They were still a big device.
1999, Depeche Mode was a retro brand.
They were great.
But also CDs were also, we were at that intersection where CDs were becoming more popular, tapes were dying out. The iPod, don't forget, was still 2 years away. 2001, the iPod was introduced, so this was how we listened to our music on the go as well.
I remember when they first came out, they jumped. Yes. Yeah, you'd have to be careful.
Although the big thing is it had skip protection. That was a big feature, skip protection. That was massive for the CDs.
See, now, you know I'm not into computers. I didn't have any of these gadgets.
Did you have
at all?
What
You're
about
trying to work the facts still.
Didn't you like watching TV on the go?
No.
This was how you watch television if you wanted to move around. I sit down in front of the telly. But if you were out and about, this was the way to catch up with your favourite shows. Oh. So we will do this all on our phones now, but this was a 2.3-inch colour television.
She was just too busy trying to get Ollie to watch the telly, weren't she?
Very good.
You look closely, it's got one of Jono's intros on it.
I want to go back. 1999 Tech. Thank you so much, Steve.
My pleasure. Thank you.